To avoid destruction from an alien attack, Captain Global gives the order to perform a fold operation. However, the resulting space-time warp has transported not only the SDF-1, but part of Macross Island and even some of the surrounding ocean far out into space, depositing everything somewhere near the orbit of Pluto. The entire population of the island is now sheltered somewhat uneasily inside the gigantic battlecruiser. Slowly, the inhabitants have picked up the pieces of their lives and are now doing their best to return to a normal lifestyle. If you can call living inside a battlecruiser floating in the middle of space normal. We wasted half the day standing in line for this.
We were lucky to get anything.
Hi, you two. How'd it go?
Oh, about as well as could be expected, I guess.
I'm feeling much better now.
Oh, I'm so glad to hear that. And how is Rick? Is he up yet?
I believe he's still in bed.
I'm not surprised. After watching over you for 2 weeks, I'd say he deserves a rest.
I guess you're right about that. Oh, by the way, Aunt Lena, are you going to leave everything like this, or will you reopen the restaurant?
What do you mean, reopen the restaurant?
We have everything we need, so I'm sure it'd be no problem. It'll be fun.
Maybe so, but it's awfully difficult to run a restaurant when these are all the rations they give you.
Is that all they gave you? But you kept your place open all through the war, and you didn't have any problems, did you?
Huh? Well, that was much different. Uh-huh. Well, the Army had imposed food rationing then, too.
But we're living inside a spaceship, Min-May.
I wouldn't worry at all about that. Once the authorities know that you're thinking of reopening the restaurant, Aunt Lena, they'll give you lots of supplies. What do you think?
I don't know. I suppose it doesn't sound like a bad idea after all.
I guess so. Doing business as usual could be the answer to a lot of problems, right?
Right. Let's get cracking. Full steam ahead.
Wait just a second. I'll be right back. I'm just going to change my clothes.
I'm glad she's excited.
I only hope we're not making a mistake about this.
No, we're not.
That's it. Easy now. Okay, turn it around. Good. Easy now. This should do it. Right here.
Everybody will see this.
Well, what's all this about?
A little surprise, Mr. Mayor. We're reopening our restaurant, that's what.
Huh? Have you gone completely crazy? Has it ever occurred to you that we are at the edge of the universe in the belly of a spaceship?
No, Mr. Mayor, we never thought of that. But even though we are in a spaceship lost in outer space, we can still have life as usual. I mean, this is still our good old hometown, isn't it?
By gosh, Min-May, you're perfectly right.
We saw it, but we couldn't believe it. Are you really open?
We certainly are. Welcome to our Chinese restaurant. Please come in, all of you. There you go. And for you, and one for you. And welcome to the first Chinese restaurant in space.
Thank you. It's an honor to be here. Hey, you're that girl, Min-May, that everyone's been talking about. I bet you had some pretty incredible adventures.
Yeah, sometimes it was pretty scary.
I heard it was just you and that what's-his-name, that kid, alone for 2 weeks. What were you doing all that time?
What do you mean?
Oh, I think you know.
Come on, it's obvious.
Oh, you make me sick.
You mean nothing happened? Nothing at all?
That's right.
Speaking of what's-his-name, is he still around? I mean, I heard he was living here or something.
Yes, he rents a room upstairs. Why?
You're saying with all that you went through together that nothing happened? You didn't fall in love or anything?
Don't be ridiculous. Rick is just a friend. Now, are you going to order or what?
All right. I'll have some chow mein.
Yeah, me too.
Right, then that'll be 3 chow mein.
Right.
So, we're just friends, huh?
We're going to be marooned here until we die, so please hold me, Rick. Please hold me tight.
After everything that happened, the very next day, we're just friends?
What do you think? Is the main gun usable or not?
Captain, sir. Look at the schematic, sir. This is a first-level diagram of the primary reflex furnace and the energy conversion unit for the main gun. Between the two lies the energy conduit for the fold system.
Which means that after the fold system disappeared, this section split, correct? In that case, then, what are you planning to do since we haven't very much spare conduit left?
Unless I'm mistaken, Captain, the STF's component systems appear to be modular. Though, simplistically speaking, you should by all rights be able to exchange this module for this one.
Very well.
The main problem is that until the modular transformation is completed, the main gun simply cannot be fired.
What modular transformation?
There will be some major changes occurring, both internally and externally. In fact, it's going to be quite a mess for a while.
Don't we have any other way to fire the main gun?
If you mean besides a modular transformation, sir, no other ways that I know of.
So, we just can't. The people are only now starting to get used to being here. To throw them into confusion again... No, it would be just too much.
Can I have two orders of egg foo young and a milkshake, please?
Oh, hi, Rick.
Boy, what a mess.
Hey, Rick. Now, show me this junk pile.
What junk pile? Listen, buddy, this is the racer I won 8 international championships in, and you call it junk? I ought to knock your block off, Roy.
Actually, it's very nice junk. But them's the breaks, kiddo. Hey, I've got an idea. Let's take a walk, okay?
Huh?
I've never seen you so depressed in my life. What you need is exercise. Try it. You'll like it.
Hey, wow. An aircraft carrier connected to the Robotech ship? Deep space.
Those Veritech fighter engines are built on a reactor design. With that kind of propulsion, believe me, you can go anywhere.
Wow, terrific.
How'd you like to fly one again, huh?
Huh? What do you mean?
Join us, Rick. Join the Robotech forces and quit all this moping around.
I don't want to be a fighter pilot.
Oh, you'd rather drag yourself all over the ship like a lovesick idiot. Well, Rick?
Roy?
Hmm?
Roy, I think I'm... I mean, do you think it's possible for a girl to change overnight? I mean, completely?
What was that?
Can a girl really change completely from what she was before?
I wouldn't worry about it much. Minmay thought you were depressed, and it was her idea for me to come up here and have a little chat with you. So just cheer up and go on back to Minmay, kid. She's waiting for you. Oh, one thing. Girls like her can be sort of fickle sometimes, know what I mean? You better be careful some guy in uniform doesn't come along. See ya.
Thanks, Roy.
Robotech shall return after these messages. This monitor shall now return to Robotech.
What? Transvids of the alien beings?
Yes, if you would care to look at the monitor, Commander. These were taken from one of the reconnaissance vessels. I believe you'll find them intriguing.
What are they?
Precisely.
So the inhabitants here are Micronians, eh?
I brought these to you as soon as I could. During my researches into the origin of the Micronians, in our most ancient records, I found an old legend.
What legend?
It presented a warning to the Zentradis to keep our hands off any Micronian planet.
I'm to keep my hands off any Micronian planet, eh? Humbug.
It is my considered opinion, my lord, that we should cease relations with this planet immediately. I also consider it prudent counsel that we maintain constant tracking maneuvers on that battlecruiser.
Very well, then. I suggest we fold immediately. Certainly. And go after them. And see to it that an appropriate reconnaissance vessel is sent out immediately after we commence the fold.
Yes, my lord.
Oh, you're back, Rick. Anything special on your mind?
Nothing, Minmay, really.
I'm sure. Come on in, Rick. Make yourself at home. Oh, could you open the window?
Oh, yeah, sure. Be glad to.
So, what happened?
Huh? Not much happened. But it's nice to be back in here. Hey, don't tell me you got mail in here. I don't believe it. Where did this come from, anyway?
That's what I went back for. I was returning to get that when you rescued me.
A love letter, huh?
Don't be silly. You can take a look at it if you like.
What's this about? A singing audition? You got to the preliminaries?
That's right. I can hardly believe it.
Huh. What? This says you were accepted for the Miss Macross competition. Miss Macross?
Yeah.
Well, I guess it's no surprise. You really sing well.
Thank you, Rick. But this isn't the Earth, so it's all sort of pointless, isn't it? Who cares if I'm a star here?
Minmay, don't be upset. It doesn't matter if this isn't our home. You can always audition again when we get back to Earth.
If we get back to Earth. Rick?
Huh?
Do you ever dream, Rick?
Do I dream?
Uh-huh.
Dream? Yes, I used to have a dream, Minmay. Now it's a pile of junk.
Are you talking about your airplane?
Yeah, I'm never gonna have another dream again.
Oh, Rick.
Radar reports an unidentified object bearing 6277, possibly of alien origin.
Enemy starships!
They've come. All right, then. Prepare an immediate counterattack.
Aye, aye, Captain. Enemy attack. Repeat, enemy attack. This is not a drill.
Don't worry about anything. Roy will take care of it, as usual.
How come you're always talking about Roy's flying? You're just as good a pilot as he is any day.
Better up here than they were back on Earth. I'm afraid we're gonna have a tough one this time.
Our decoy missile is now within their firing range.
I find it strange. They haven't fired the main gun yet.
What are you planning, my dear Micronian friend?
Perhaps we should give them another present and see what they do.
Very good idea. Tell the recon ship to open fire, but try to minimize damages. Understand? Just pray.
There's been some damage to the reactor subcontrol, Captain, but we'll manage.
I'm counting on you.
thundering asteroids! Another direct hit.
Captain, damage control reports that the second and fifth plasma cannons have sustained heavy damage. They say it will be impossible to repair them quickly.
Number four engine is almost completely destroyed.
Self-control systems report considerable damage and casualties.
That's the last straw. We're firing the main gun. We will now execute Dr. Lang's designated modular transformation.
But if we do that, it means the whole town might just...
Yes, that's right.
I have no choice. We have to do it.
All systems attention. All systems attention. Commence maneuvering for firing of main gun.
Transformation to initiate in 3 minutes.
They can't be doing a transformation now.
They're out of their minds.
2 minutes, 30 seconds. Huh? Attention all citizens. This ship will be undergoing a modular transformation in 60 seconds.
Transformation? What's that?
I don't know.
Oh. I guess Roy must be out there fighting about now.
You mean you think I should join the Defense Force?
No, I didn't mean that at all. It's just that airplanes are your dream, aren't they?
Well, I guess. But if I go and join the Defense Force, Minmay, I won't be able to see much of you anymore.
Rick, we're in the same ship. On our days off, we can see each other whenever we want to.
If I survive.
Oh, Rick, how can you say that? All the soldiers who come to our restaurant are in exactly the same position.
Oh, yeah? The same position? You'd be the one to know now, wouldn't you?
What?
10 seconds to transformation.
All sections on execution standby?
D&G blocks are a bit late, but they'll manage.
Continue.
Counting 4 seconds. 3, 2, 1, 0.
Execute the full ship transformation.
Commence full ship transformation, J, K, and L blocks.
D-block 78 sections started.
Full ship transformation underway, sir.
Very good.
You know, Minmay, sometimes I think it would have been better if they'd never found us.
I can't believe I'm hearing that from you. How can you be so cruel? Oh, I hate you!
Well, the same goes for me, too, then. If you want me to...
Another attack formation is approaching from 1093.
Disregard. Fire the main gun.
Yes, sir.
Get me a full damage report on all sections immediately.
Whatever damage that has occurred is regrettable. However, we fired the main gun and completely destroyed the enemy ship. Thank you for your cooperation. Please report any casualties, injuries, or damages to your section shelter officer as soon as possible.
Well, Rick, you said you wanted to destroy the town. How do you like it?
But I didn't actually expect anything to happen.
Oh, I wonder if our restaurant was destroyed.
Minmay, I'm gonna do it.
Huh?
I'm gonna join the defense forces.
Oh, Rick.
You're right. It's no good my moping around. I'm gonna enlist.
Oh.
All right, boys, let's head for home.
In the next exciting episode of Robotech, the Zentradi are still puzzled by the actions of the SDF-1. However, Britai, their commander, is beginning to enjoy the challenge. Captain Global plans a trap for the marauding aliens, only to have it backfire among the incredible rings of Saturn. And Rick is trapped inside a Zentradi warship. Don't miss Blitzkrieg, the next exciting episode of Robotech.